Welcome to the Rooms and Ceilings video for the Chief Architect Bachelor View Project. In this video, I'll place some of the interior walls, adjust a few of the walls to be solid railing walls where the ceilings are vaulted, use the custom ceiling plane to vault one of the rooms, and then use the soffits to create a coffered ceiling, and then finally the automatic tray ceiling tool to create a tray ceiling in our office. Let's begin by placing some of the interior walls. I have the project file open from the last video in creating the foundation floor and the daylight basement. From the save plan view, let's go ahead and change this to the interior view. And I'm going to end up drawing most of these interior walls in a 3D view, so it'll be a little bit easier for you to see. Now, earlier in the project, we had defined this room over here on the right as our garage room. And on part of this room, I want to create a wall right in this area, and then draw a few more segments for the pantry, the mudroom, and the powder room. Let's go over to our interior wall tool, and one of the first things that I'm going to do is double click on the wall. When we did our basement, we had changed the default wall type to the interior fur. I'm going to change this interior four back to just the regular interior four wall, and now I can come over here and drag out our wall. And then one more wall over in here that's going to be used for the storage room. And before I add any additional walls in this area, you're going to notice that the floor material is a concrete. I'm going to click near the edge of the wall, press the tab key so I can get the room selection. I can't click directly on the floor since the room definition is supplied by the floor below in this garage scenario. Now that I have the room selected, let's double click, open it up, and I'm going to give this room definition as a kitchen, and then I'll go ahead and type over it and call it a pantry. That way it will inherit properties from the kitchen, and that way when I add additional walls in here, and then one more wall up in here, I'll go ahead and drag that all the way across, and then over, a wall over here to define the bedroom, and then in here for the closet. And then down in this area, we're going to draw a short wall that's going to define the kitchen area. I'm going to draw a 6-inch wall that will divide this area. And in this case, let's go ahead and open it up, change it to an interior 6 wall. And then for room definition between the entryway and the kitchen area, I'm going to use the room divider tool. We'll come in here, drag out a room divider, and that will provide us room definition right in this area for the kitchen. Now I'm going to go ahead and speed ahead and add the interior walls for the master wing area over in this area. For the master bedroom, let's go ahead and take a look at the ceiling in here. Let's double click on the room. In the room drop-down, let's go ahead and name it. On the structure panel, as you know, Chief Architect automatically generates a flat ceiling when you form a room. Let's remove the flat ceiling out of this space. As you may recall, we had created a shed roof style over this space that will open that room up. In the kitchen area, and actually this entire area, we also have a shed style ceiling, and I'm going to open up this room and make the same change. On the structure panel, remove the flat ceiling option, and for the rooms in the back, these three individual rooms, let's go back into the floor plan view. Let's use the object eyedropper. I'm going to pick up the properties of the main room without the ceiling. I'm going to apply it onto those three individual rooms. All right, let's take a 3D view with the ceiling on. Now for the shed ceiling in this section of the design, you're going to notice that in the roof area right here, we remove the ceiling, but the roof is coming in with this cricket in here. And if we zoom inside here, let's take a look. You can see that cricket right in here. Opening up that ceiling creates this odd shape. I'm going to use the custom ceiling plane tool and draw a slope ceiling that will then cover that up. The other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grab these two walls on the side, hold my shift key down, grab both of them. On the general panel of the wall, I'm going to change them to railings. And then for the wall cap, I'm just going to place a wall cap on top of that wall. You'll find that underneath sills and caps. I'm just going to use a basic rectangular style cap. We'll have it go the full length. And now you can see how that opens up that space. This will be our kitchen alcove right in this area. Now let's go back over into our floor plan view. And I want to change my plan view to the ceiling plan view. That will change the layer in my default settings. And then using the manual ceiling plane tool, let's come down here. And I'm just going to click and drag along this wall, go up slope, click to the other wall, and then I'll go ahead and fill in the space. I usually don't worry about being too exact when I first draw that. Let's open up the ceiling plane. When you draw these, they will come in at the default pitch of the roof. For these walls, we overrode the default pitch and changed it to 3 and 12. Notice that I have the inside wall locked on the height at 121 and an eighth. That's the appropriate thing I want to do before I change the pitch to 3 and 12. And now when you go into the 3D view, you can see that we've covered and taken care of that cricket in the roof above. Now to have this ceiling bare on something, I'm going to draw a ceiling beam in here, and again go back into the ceiling plan view, and you're going to find this tool underneath of our framing tool for the floor and ceiling beam. I'm just going to come right in this area right here. We'll click and drag across. This is using the default properties of my beam. If we open it up and take a look, the default beam that I'm using is 12 inches. It's 4 inches in width. It's a steel eye, and it's also a bearing beam when it does the framing. Now, if you do more framing on this, typically you're going to put a steel post that would go down to the foundation in this intersection and in this intersection. And when you look at the completed plan, you'll see that detail so that that beam is able to spread and cover the load. Now for the tray ceiling, let's take a look. This is our office space right in here. Let's use our camera tool and point and click in this direction of the room. This office room currently has a 10-foot ceiling. We're going to put some cabinets and a fireplace in here. And then for this ceiling style, I want to create a tray style ceiling. Click on the bottom of the floor in here. You're going to find the Make Tray Ceiling in Room tool. Now using this tool, you can define the width, which is going to be the distance where my cursor is in from the wall. I'm going to set that to be 18 inches. The depth, which will be coming down, 12 inches. You can recess that into the ceiling if you'd like. My pitch is vertical. If you want to change that in a pitch in degrees, you could do that. You can also come in here, uncheck the vertical, and you could change that to maybe an 8 and 12 pitch. I'm going to leave mine at vertical. You can change the structure if you're going to have this framed. In my case, I'm going to go ahead and set this to just be maybe a 2x6. So we'll go ahead and set that to be 5.5 and just a general lumber material in there for that. On the moldings, my default plan already has a molding set up for tray ceilings. I'm going to use this profile. You can see it down here. And then for rope lighting, I'd like to put a small LED rope right above that molding. You can control the offset both horizontally and vertically, also true for the moldings. Once you place these tray ceilings, you can easily modify them in your plan view. They can be blocked, they can be repositioned however you'd like to change them. If you want to make those adjustments, just press the undo. That same tool will also work in your plan view. Select the room, you can come down, you'll find the same Make Tray Ceiling. You can also nest these ceilings and create a variety of different styles. If you're creating a ceiling plan, you can come in and use your text tool. I'll come over, click in the room, and I'll just go ahead and put some text in here. You can fill out the text. These come in on the specific layer for ceiling. If you switch back to your floor plan view, notice that that text is not being displayed. My active view underneath the ceiling is actually controlling what layers these are going on. If you take a look at my completed ceiling plan in the project, you can see all of the different annotations that I've made to make sure that it's very clear what style of ceiling and what the elevations of the ceiling are. Now in the last segment of the video, let's go down to the foundation level. You'll notice that I already filled in the interior walls in here. Let's use our 3D camera and peek at this room. And since I have a glass wall back in here for the wine room, let's go ahead and toggle our camera on to the vector view. What I want to do is use the soffit tool, and I want to create a coffer in the upper ceiling. Let's go into the floor plan view and draw those soffits out for that coffer. You'll find the soffits underneath of the cabinet tool. And a lot of times before I click and place a soffit, if I'm going to do very many of them, I'll double click on the tool and I'll set the properties for the soffit. Let's go ahead and set it to be 6 inches in height, same for the depth. And then as far as the floor to top, floor to bottom, I'd like to set this at the ceiling height, which should be the finished ceiling height 119 5/8. Now that I have those properties set, it's going to make the process a little bit quicker to draw this. Let's go ahead and start with our first soffit right in this area. We'll zoom in a little bit. I'm going to take this soffit and let's just bump it up against this glass wall, and I'm going to go ahead and slide it into place. For this coffer, we're going to create a symmetrical look to it. Let's use our multiple copy tool, and I'm going to set this multiple copy at 44 inches. Let's go ahead and drag out the first copy of this soffit, and then I'm going to go ahead and drag it out right about in this area right here. Then I'm just going to use the exact same tool, the multiple copy tool. It's already got 44 inches loaded in it. Come down here, I'm going to pull a series of soffits down. On this last one, we'll go ahead and make the adjustment. I'm going to copy this, Control C on the keyboard, Control V. I'm going to paste a copy of that in here. Again, make some adjustments so that it bumps up against the two different areas. And now I'm going to use the exact same tool, the multiple copy. We'll slide that down till we get to the end. Make a couple of adjustments in here, pull that up to the wall, and then when we go back into our 3D camera, you can see the coffer. Might look a little bit better if I toggle this on to the standard view, and you can see the coffer effect adding a nice texture into the ceiling. And when you look at the completed renderings here, you can see what this looks like with the finished room in the space. Well, that concludes this segment of the rooms and ceiling video for the Bachelor View project. In the next segment of the video, I'll take a look at placing doors and windows and some of the custom framing to create a unique look.